Hi, I'm Justin Cates, Director of Emergency Management for the City of Nashua, New Hampshire, and a board member at the National Alliance for Public Safety GIS Foundation, NAVSIG. For the last few years, I've been amazed by how important project management skills are in my work to create and organize innovative solutions for challenges that end up on my plate as an emergency manager. I've recognized that while all project managers are not emergency managers, all emergency managers are project managers. Our technology staff are well-versed in these concepts, but the rest of us have not had the same opportunity to apply these methodologies in our work. In this session, you'll hear about how to apply strong project management, design, and development skills in your programs and get an idea of where to look to learn more. First, Robert Pitts and Madeline Jones from New Light Technologies will provide an overview of key project management methodologies. They'll provide strategies, a series of vignettes that will walk you through project management fundamentals, tools, and techniques, as well as provide you with a high-level awareness of the agile approach to managing projects. They'll close it out by providing a case study on how they leverage project management techniques in their work with the FEMA Response Geospatial Office and provide you with best practices in implementing these skills in your organization. Next, we talk with Emily Marticello of FEMA Region 1 on the application of design thinking and human-centered design within emergency management. Kim Stevens from FEMA's crowdsourcing unit, along with representatives from Esri and GIS Corps, provide a case study on how they use human-centered design as they designed a faster and more accurate damage assessment approach in the aftermath of Hurricane Laura. Moving into our next project development and design methodology, we explore the Lean Launchpad methodology with Dr. Rodrigo Nieto Gomez from the Naval Postgraduate School's Center for Homeland Defense and Security. This approach is used frequently in startup business development and incorporates a useful tool called the Business Model Canvas, robust customer development, and the agile approach that were mentioned in Rob and Madeline's sessions. We follow it up with a case study from Dr. Sid Soleil from the Colorado School of Mines on how they implemented this approach in their Hacking for Homeland Security and InnovateX programs in partnership with FEMA and the Department of Homeland Security. Sid interviews a number of project contributors and is available for office hours to answer your questions on this initiative. Finally, we close this session with an introduction of FEMA's Continuous Improvement Planning Toolkit and their new rapid improvement process, which leverages lean and agile principles to help organizations make corrective actions during an emergency. This approach was used successfully by FEMA Region 1 to redesign emergency management processes during COVID-19, and we will likely see more of this in this field. There are many hours of content here, and it's really just meant to provide you with an overview of the various project management, design, and development approaches that are out there. While technologists that are attending Inspire are very likely familiar with many of these concepts, we hope decision makers and public safety practitioners will take some time to learn more about how they can apply these tools to their work. If you're interested in learning more, we've provided a PDF on this page with dozens more links, training, templates, and other free resources. Thanks to Tricia Lawson and the NAVSIG team for helping to coordinate this session and make it a reality. I hope that every Inspire attendee learns something and is able to implement one of these approaches back at their organization. Thanks.